Joining us on the line at this time, as we continue to look at all that's taking place, we have the president of the medical board. And the reason we're speaking to Dr. Varma Dyal Singh is that according to international reports, and I'm going to quote this, economic issues are being totally driven by health issues. You tell me how long we'll be at home, and then I will tell you how long it will take for the economy to recover. That is the findings of a paper issued by MIT. According to that paper, the choice is not between health and economics, but about optimizing the public health response to save lives. How do we fit into all of this? And the fact is that over the weekend, the Prime Minister began the reopening of the country. But Varma Dyal Singh only recently said that the lockdown should continue for another month. We're going to find out this morning why the president of the medical board is asking and pleading with those who can convince or those who can influence policy to be cautious and be a little more conservative. Good morning, Mr. Dyal Singh. How are you?
Morning. Thank you, Ima. Fine. Thank you.
Now, let me start with your quotes initially. First, let's start with Saturday. Right before Saturday, you made a statement in the Senate talking that maybe the lockdown should continue for another period, a longer period. Why did you feel that way?
Well, I felt that way because you have to look what's going on. The psychology of changing people, having a behavioral change. This takes a time to kick into certain person. And why I took that line is because we know people are hard. We heard the Prime Minister, actually come out and try to tell people they have to do better. Now, I was hoping that within this period, we pass certain legislation that would afford us a safer society out there. Because even before him, I had called in the Senate for legislation having it mandatory to have social distancing. So you would have a fine if you are too close to somebody. And even now, after that, I've asked for the fact that we should have mandatory wearing of face masks when we go out. So therefore, having these positions, actually put into law, I'm saying if you have to slap people, slap them with legislation, because a certain amount of our population will be delinquent. You see in the roads how people don't even obey the road traffic, they are the shoulder. So therefore, this concept of social distancing, this concept of wearing a mask, of their personal responsibility, of their social responsibility, is not there. So we have to now say there's a segment of people who will definitely do that because they understand the danger. There's a segment of the population will go willy-nilly and just, don't care. And those are the persons I'm thinking we have to put things in place where legislation is in place, where we are now having the a hotline so you can call in if you see somebody. You have to have things in place where people could look and see what's out there and how we can prevent it. You see, our vulnerability with this. I mean, we're in a good place now. I expected more deaths. So I'm thinking the CMO, the Minister of Health, the Minister of National Security for the lockdown, good measures. We are in a good place, but we can't let this go out of hand. We've seen what's happening in Japan. Japan has now, you find things a second wave, and it's nearly 1,000 times bigger than the first wave. South Korea, a guy who was back up in China, a laundry worker went and infected her relatives. So we want to prevent that. So I'm saying, yes, the lockdown I asked for was from, I think it was with somebody, the first mayor. I'm thinking within that month, we put things in place. And definitely, if we have these things in place, I'm thinking we'll have a greater level of comfort.
Now, the business community, Dr. Dyal Singh, is asking for, you speak from a position as president of the medical board. So obviously, you're looking at the medicine and the science behind this. The Prime Minister has said that his decisions will be influenced by data and also by the science and the medicine in this matter. The business community is clamoring that maybe a less conservative approach should have been used and that the balancing act was not done in their favor. Do you agree with what the Prime Minister presented on Saturday, or do you think that we should have remained home a little longer?
No, you have to appease the business community. You have to appease the workers. You have to actually realize people are frustrated at their home. And job loss is something we look at. But you see, if you're going to have that release, you have to do it in a manner where there's a responsibility. For instance, business places, they want to open. They have to know they're going to have staff. They're going to rotate the staff. They're not going to fire people willy-nilly because, remember, some businesses may use that as an opportunity to fire people. Scatter their staff in working hours and have the protocols where, if the public generally coming into your business space. You have to have your sanitizing area, gloves if they're going to touch goods and whatnot. Mask, I'm thinking, should be there. Apply them with gloves or either sanitize your hands when they're touching any goods in your store. And you're going to cut down the chance. And even if you look at the business places, let's say, for instance, Port of Spain or any of the major cities, if you're going to start opening the business places, they can do it in a phased manner. For instance, Monday, Wednesday, and Friday open one side, and the other side businesses open another day. So if you have a congestion of people on the pavement, you can easily cross to the other side because, you know, on the other side, there's no sort of business. So they can do it in that way. But while they are doing that, now you'll have the vigilance seeing what, where are the failures in the system. People are not working with their masks. And you have to know, I'm saying, if you legislate against that, you'll be able to put ease.
Now, that would have been my other question. Should the government have gone the route of legislating to say that all businesses need to have these things put in place, that to be out in the public space, you need to be wearing a mask?
Yes, but I think first of all, the government, if the government allows for the opening without any restrictions, they will be neglecting that chance. Because if people start to spread it, they can spread to our children. People have to understand that younger people are being affected. So government, I think, has to go with the way of legislation. They know the persons, some persons are not obeying. Legislate for face masks. Once you're in a public space, you have to put a face mask on. Even though you're in groups around the savannah, walking or whatnot, have your face mask. So that's the first thing. Legislate for the face mask, for social distances. So any business space that we find, you know, that let us say the business space themselves, the health inspectors would go into restaurants and certain places and OSHA will go in. They will see how many people will be allowed in an establishment because of their size, what sort of protocols they're going to have for people entering. And also, if a business place is seen in breach of that, close them down. If a food establishment, because we saw the fiasco in Arima, if a food establishment, people are out there. If you have if you want to open a business, hire security.
But what do you say?
What
do you say? I'm trying to get. What do you say to the business community who believe that? Because you are saying that a lot needs to be done before we kind of fully reopen the economy. And I see that in the U.S., they are saying even though unemployment has peaked at about 15%. That according to scientists and according to medical officials, that the outbreak has neither peaked nor has it plateaued, and there's still a lot of infections out there. So what would you say to the business community? And this is a very strange balancing act that the Prime Minister must do at this time. What do you say to them when they're saying that let's reopen now, or more should be reopened now?
Well, the thing is, when I made that statement, it was about almost 2 weeks ago, so we're now 2 weeks in. I still need that satisfaction that yes, the people will be responsible, and even though the persons themselves don't have that individual responsibility, I want to see that the business places are put under some sort of restriction. Even government offices, if they have people coming in a crowd, if they have people outside lining up without masks, you know, they should also be on breach of some sort of regulation. You see, let us say we open Port of Spain, Emma, what we are actually seeing there, what are we going to do with the street vendors? That has always been an issue. Those are poor people who are trying to get a living. We have to put something in place for them. What are we going to do with the socially displaced who could spread this if they sneeze and cough amongst the people there? But you see, if the persons have their gear on, you're cutting down that chart.
Sure.
Something that not all is lost, you know, because, I mean, Trinidad, as I'm saying, even with tourists, right now, two things are worrying me about Trinidad. We're going into the flu season, and we are also going into the rainy season, so more people will be indoors. So that is two things we have to look at. So we have to put these in place. So good, responsible businessmen, have your business open, have these policies that government could institute and also close you down. Government also, we need to know, and even like tourism, that is something that could take off, you know, because remember right now, people will want to get away from the winter. They can still come to Tobago. We can still sell Tobago sun, sea, and COVID-free because we are a success so far with the COVID. So people come in here, they can quarantine in a hotel for 14 days before they're allowed to leave. And so therefore, we started opening hotels and but just the ground floor. So we can take this and spin it to our way also.
Do you agree with the Prime Minister's approach, Dr. Dayal Singh?
I can see his frustration, but I'm thinking he has to understand the nature of our people, and he has to put the laws into place. So you put laws into place for social distancing, you put laws into place for masks, you put laws into place for business and government offices, if they are virtually some sort of structure. And if you have that in place, then I'm thinking we are in a more comfortable level. We can't just lift our foot off the brake. We have to do a gradual stuff. And you see, what I'm saying is, yes, the rules now for food inspectors to go into restaurants, you have to give them a little added rule. You're going to look at places, see what's happening. The rules for OSHA inspectors to make sure workers and your business place like even masks and you know, all these are things we have to look out for. We have to look at the municipal police, community police going into buildings to be able areas to see if people are lining up outside a gyro store. Police will have to come in and see if we can stop that. You see, look, I'm saying the instances that we have seen, the little spikes coming back, the second wave coming back, it can come.
Yeah, and that's the mm-hmm. other question I want to ask. You know, looking at even from the examples of the U.S., which their health system is a lot larger, their population is a lot larger, but they have also, there's this fear, and you cited the example of Japan, that if not handled properly, that the second wave can essentially crumble a country. The health system will be the first to go and everything else will follow. So how does science and economics and medicine all find the right balance? The government has said that they will continue, or that they will take a phased reopening process, and they are hoping to expand testing. Now, I haven't seen the evidence that they've started expanding testing as yet, and I guess we will find out where that has reached. So should we wait on more tests before the dates for the next set of reopening starts?
I'm thinking what we should do, government should pass legislation, ensure within these 2 weeks that the persons who are on reach, you show an example that, hey, you cannot just go into public, you can't sneeze on people, you can't just be without a face mask. So having that testing to show that more persons would be able to be on reach, you know, because there's a social distancing law. If you close to somebody, you can find them. If you coming out in public, just as how you have to wear shirt and pants or clothes, you come out with a mask. These are easy things to put in place. But then we have now the time now to show that we are now being able to implement people who breach it. So if you're getting those persons who actually breaching the social distances and face masks and businesses who are breaching, I think we're now looking at, hey, this is the new way forward, this is the new norm. And I think our vulnerability really would be the citizens who are not heeding, you understand, heeding the safety measures. Our strength is our vigilant population, or what I would put the more cautious population culture, who will videotape something and put it online so we could see the breaches. But our saving in this really now, the government has to pass the baton from the CMO, from the Minister of Health, to now our saving in this really is Gary Griffiths, because he is the one to be having his staff go around the country to see their breaches. So once we start to set an example, because we are teachers who we look at the law, I mean, we break the law, but what I'm saying, people are being breached, we are showing that we are taking it out, you know, you have to now quarantine, or you go home, or you're not allowed it, you're getting a fine. And I'm thinking, once we can show persons that we are serious about
If it is that you start reopening, like looking at some of the examples that we've seen, I know we're against the clock right now, looking at some of the examples that we've seen, there was an image coming out of Arima, I think it is, where persons were all congregating outside. I think it was one of those doubles vans or one of those food vans. If it is that we're seeing evidence like that, what advice would you then give the government if that becomes the norm of how people are behaving?
That is why about 2 months ago in Parliament, I suggested legislation. So people are there, you are now not social distancing, you're going to get a fine. You're not wearing a face mask, you can't come out there. You're also closed down that business establishment. Part of your responsibility for opening is you have to, if you're in breach of that law. So what I'm saying, that should show us that the legislation is much needed to get a greater level of safety as we move forward.
Sure. Dr. Dayal Singh, I do want to thank you very much for giving us your thoughts and sharing your opinion. Dr. Dayal Singh is the president of the Medical Board, talking about the fact that it is a balance. He understands all sides. He initially 2 weeks ago said that the lockdown should have been extended for another month to ensure that persons are aware of the type of behavior needed. He said from the evidence seen that persons can become complacent and we cannot afford for a second wave to crumble and break this economy. His advice, government should legislate behavior. We take a short break. When we come back, we're going to have more for you. Stay with us. This is The Morning Brew.